Hi guys, it's Thursday. We're going to Hawaii today, but first I am going to go get a spray tan because I'm very pale. I've been very good about wearing sunscreen, but I want to be tan. I'm gonna hit the lounge, get some food. It's been a long time since I've been to the airport.
It's been like 2 months.
It's been 12 hours.
Nice.
Sam's making a bingo card for this trip. Okay, so
I have one. It is if someone goes surfing and they slice their foot.
Oh, I'm literally just about to put that on.
No way.
Hours of flying and he didn't finish the bingo board.
I got busy.
Hey, Monica's showing me to my room.
Okay, I made sure that the mini split works really well.
Oh good. Whoa, look, that's so crazy, the water right there. Okay, wow,
it's cool.
What a maze.
So it stays really cool.
Oh, I love a mini split. Oh,
are you cool with this?
Yeah, duh, why? Yeah, yeah.
I start getting like.
Alright, we're starting this day surfing. Sam was very determined. You're going out already?
Wait, what?
Oh my god.
Here's my board. The Aperol King.
This is perfect to pre-mix. I'm gonna pre-mix it.
Monica challenged me to a game of chess. And you warmed up last night, you played, so.
But I'm just so bad.
I'm at a disadvantage.
Dom, Baylor.
And there's a race that's about to go down, so this is pretty cool. Good morning, guys. It's day two in Hawaii. Two out of our three full days. I am really tempted to stay longer because me and Sam's friend, Kevin, who is recently in LA, lives in Maui and was like, oh, you guys can come stay with me. And so I'm like, let's go. But I'm gonna get ready this morning. Everyone's moving a little bit slower. Okay, I'm trying to convince Monica to come play tennis. There is like an abandoned court over here. So I'm trying to hit that up. Putting on a little makeup, but not a ton, because I think I'm gonna go swimming. So just some like waterproof mascara. Okay, simple, just put on like a little makeup, but not a lot, because it's definitely gonna get washed off. Okay, I've seen people use brow gel to like slick back their hair. Oh God, wow, okay, that kind of worked.
Stadium.
Yeah, no, it looks like they used to have like a few rooms. So there's a couple courts still kind of intact. I think this'll do. See, there's like stuff growing, but it's the balls might hit a little weird, but it should work kinda.
Let's crack open a fresh can.
Oh,
That looks good. Nice.
Monica's killing it, you guys. So this is right by the Wander. Very nice.
Monica, get the shot.
Hanging out at the Wander. We're watching them surf from afar.
Going to brunch. It's our last day. I'm wearing the outfit that I've had a vision for this whole time.
Woo! Rip.
That was so good.
You ripped.
Look how it is. They were nice. I think we got two whales here. I think it's a mom and a baby.
Review of the boat tour.
It was really fun.
It was fun. Okay, Monica and I just played a little bit. And we're gonna go in the ocean or the hot tub or something. But that was nice, just after eating so we can get a little movement in today. Cord's so busted. Good job, team.
Last coffee.
And I got a very weird night of sleep, but I'm up now. We're gonna try and get some stuff done. Okay, guys, I am going through the tipping culture video and finding all the timestamps. I like to do timestamps and just making sure it's like totally done. And then I'm getting on a call in a little bit with Rob and our one person who's giving us a bid for building the house. So how much it would cost, which is gonna be cool. Similar. Yeah. I think we're looking at potentially just normal sliders too. Yeah, like how important do we think the door is? Whereas before you just wouldn't see the post at all, like would it be in the wall or something? Okay, my place is crazy right now because I left in a hurry and need to unpack and everything, but I have no food left. So let's go get some and I finished the tipping video. It's uploading right now.
Field trip to two different places.
Let's get ready. Sam and I are back from Kauai. It was such a quick trip. It felt like it was over so fast because it was really fun. I didn't really vlog a lot because we were with a group of people that are not YouTubers, so I didn't really want to as much. I just got a few clips, but it was a very fun time. And actually, cool thing, Wander now, because we stayed at a Wander, they have a referral program where you can get $250 off your first Wander, which I feel like is really good. Back when Airbnb did that, and I think they still have a referral thing, it's only like $20 off. That's amazing, $250 off. So if you're ever looking to book a Wander, definitely use that. I'll link my code if you want to use it, if you're ever booking a Wander and you want that $250 off. Because they are pricey, right? But it's because the houses are very big. And so when you split it with a lot of people, it's actually usually better than a hotel. The Wander was, it was awesome there. But anyway, I got a lot of comments on my last vlog, many of you guys asking if I still think it's worth it to get a real estate license with that new NAR lawsuit. Okay, so if you guys aren't familiar, there was a lawsuit that basically made it so that real estate agents will probably get less commissions. Normally, if you buy real estate, as a buyer, you don't pay your buyer's agent the commission. It's actually the seller that pays the buyer's agent commission. They pretty much made it so that is not what's happening anymore. So it makes it more expensive for the buyers because they have to come up with the money up front. But it also makes it where more people are aware of how much that amount is. And so I do think that buyer's agents in real estate are
gonna make less money because a lot of people are gonna go, whoa, I don't have the 2% commission or 3% or whatever. Cause on $1 million house, a 2% commission, yeah, a 3% commission on $1 million house, $30,000. So imagine you're going to buy a house and you have the closing costs and then you have to buck up 30 grand for the real estate agent. I think most people are gonna be like, whoa, I'm not paying that much. Which I do think in general, okay, yes, like real estate agents make like really so much for what they're doing a lot of the time. But I do think it's still worth it to get a real estate license because I've already done so much studying. I've finished the course. I've just been like memorizing the flashcards for the test. I'm like, I might as well see it through. And just because real estate agents will likely make less doesn't mean they're not gonna make nothing. I think people will probably still make a pretty decent amount. It's more likely that people are gonna charge maybe a flat fee. Like if you go to buy a house, you negotiate with the buyer's agent something different, like you'll pay 5 or 10 grand, which is still actually kind of a lot. But I don't know, it really depends because sometimes people take so long to buy a house and they have to go see a lot of things and it's like time consuming. Other times it's not a lot. It kind of makes sense that sellers should not have to pay 5 to 6% when you sell a house. Like that really is pretty crazy when you think about it. But at the same time, I kind of don't feel bad for most sellers because they are boomers who a lot of times their house is now worth like 5 times as much as when they bought it in the 80s or whatever. And so I'm almost like boo-hoo at the commission thing, you know? But that's not always the case. You know, many people buy a starter home and then they want to sell it and get something different. And wow, 5 to 6%, that's like so much. So I guess I see both sides of it. And I think overall, I bet real estate agents probably will get paid a little bit less, but they make so much right now that even a little bit less is still pretty good. So those are my thoughts on that. But yeah, I am still planning to take the test and everything because I'm like, I don't know, I just don't like the idea of quitting because of that. Working with people I think would be really cool too because YouTube is such a like a solo thing. So I don't know, I think it'd be cool. And honestly, even just the referrals with real estate. Like anyway, it's weird to get back from a trip on a Monday night. We actually didn't get back to my apartment until like 11:30 p.m. And I just couldn't sleep because of the time change. It's like a 3-hour difference from Hawaii this time of year. So I kind of slept in and then edited for a while and had an hour long call about the Joshua Tree property, about the cost of different parts of it and what we might want to change because we can cut costs on certain things. Like for example, the front door that we had planned was like a really, really big pivot door. And those are like $10,000. I did not realize that. And so we're like, actually don't think we really need that big of a door. I don't think that's that important to an Airbnb. I'd rather spend it on like a fire pit, you know? Yeah, that took like an hour, but it was fun. It was fun to like talk about the plans for the house. Okay, setting a timer to clean because I was trying to disguise this, but yeah, I need to unpack. Alright, 25 minutes did some good to my place. Now let's get back to my computer work. I'm actually gonna go work outside on a day bed. We're gonna edit some of the Hawaii vlog and honestly just figure out what else I need to film this week. All right, I did not last very long outside. It reaches a certain point of the day where you can't see your laptop anymore because there's no shade, but it always feels good to go outside, even if it's just for like 15 minutes, just like feel the sun. But I'm just gonna edit from the couch, actually. I'm letting Sam use my monitor and desk. I'm back. I got Mendocino Farms. My toxic trait is doing things when I have one cut on my foot and one blister on my foot, but I was like, but I wanna go, but I wanna go. Oh my God, my lips are so chapped. It like burns to eat this. This is just Sam reacts to me talking nonsense. How's the spritz? I'm just gonna leave it in like Family Guy. You know, they'll just like leave something in for way too long. Hello, vlog. It's Wednesday and we're gonna go on a lunch date. I'm wearing this Saison dress. I don't really like how I did my makeup or my hair today, but I wanna try and make an Instagram reel of the place. I think it would be kind of fun. We're gonna go to Great White in Venice, which is really good. If you ever visit LA or if you live here, then I'm sure you know about it, but it's on in-kind, so you can get $25 off if you spend 50, which is kind of awesome. Sim said he'd open my door. He really just doesn't trust me to not hit the sidewalk, but I'll take it. Wow, thank you. Such a gentleman.
Pretty sure.
Okay, we are back from lunch and I'm trying to make Instagram reels today. I've seen a lot of people say you need to be posting like 4 times a week, which is kind of a lot, but I posted one today and so now I'm trying to figure out maybe like an outfits one. I don't really like this outfit. I'm just like trying stuff on to be like, okay, like to show a few that I like. But again. I just made a TikTok that I know is gonna be kind of controversial. Don't mind all the mess. I'm trying to unclose. It's just, it's gonna be a mess until I finish recording these. I think I'm just kind of moving stuff around, but I might clean up a little bit more. I made a TikTok about how my Airbnb isn't booked for Coachella yet at all. You guys, it's crazy this year. Like, no one cares about Coachella. Normally, our Airbnb gets like 12 to 1500 a night for Coachella, and now we dropped it down. I think it's at like 900 and it still hasn't booked. And there's so many Airbnbs out there where everyone's dropped their price like half of what it normally is for Coachella, and just people don't care, which is understandable. You know, there's so many good music festivals out there that are less expensive than Coachella, and the lineup I think just isn't as good as normal. So we're gonna drop our price more, or honestly I might just block it off and go. I might just get a group of friends and go. I haven't really decided yet, but I'm not really shocked. Lineup is just not that good. Okay, I've made 3 TikToks. We're gonna do one. We're gonna do 2 more. The first one is about solar. I recently got $20,000 worth of solar. I recently got $20,000 worth of solar panels added to my Palm Springs Airbnb, and here's how it affected my electricity. Okay, I just made a bunch of TikToks and I did make an Instagram reel today too, but I don't know, the Instagram reels I feel like have to be more like polished looking. So I have a bunch planned and I filmed one when we went and got lunch, but I want to do a really cool one of all my tennis outfits, so I need to film it, film my outfit every time I go play, I guess. Anyway, I'm gonna clean up. It's like 4 p.m. so I'm going to a brand dinner soon.
I like this jacket of yours.